About 1 month ago, we told you about Mark Meadows, who had claimed to have been living in a cabin on top of a mountain in North Carolina, even though like that's where he was registered, but there was no evidence that he'd ever actually been there. Now that seemed weird. Well, we're not the only ones who thought that, because he's now being he's been removed from the voter rolls there, and there's an investigation going on to whether he might have violated the law in registering to vote in a place that he apparently had never lived in. It was a rented mobile home in a Scaly Mountain, sounds nice. Anyway, he voted from there as an absentee in the 2020 presidential election. He has subsequently registered to vote in Virginia. According to neighbors up on Scaly Mountain and the former owner of the property, Deborah Meadows rented and stayed at the mobile home for a few nights, but her husband was never seen there. And you can see he's shipping out. So now you can actually see the listing here if you'd like to live in a place that Mark Meadows claimed to have lived but never actually did. I don't know, maybe that's your thing. Anyway, he is being investigated for the possibility of having committed voter fraud, which is just an amazing ironic twist on this. After all of the claims of voter fraud, all of the fake investigations and the cyber ninjas and all of that, when the actual voter fraud comes out, every single time it seems to be Republicans. And I don't want you to freak out about this, because the cases are so rare that it doesn't really matter that they did this. I mean, it's illegal, but it didn't flip an election or anything. But it's such petty, ironic, like such a petty, ironic twist to this story, Nelini.
It's the one of the most pettiest things I've seen in my entire life, because it's always just one or two or three of them. So it's not even enough to overturn a complete election. But it shows to you that they have no actual values, that they have no commitment to what they are actually saying out there. They're doing it because people are concerned about these things. People are concerned about voter fraud because they've been told lies time and time and again. And instead of us all championing for something like the For the People Act that would actually bring more democracy to our elections, we're arguing about voter fraud that is actually being done by the former White House chief of staff. It's kind of, it's kind of insane.
Yeah, and an increasing number of some of their biggest supporters. So we know the Villages, this retirement community in Florida, Trump did a whole bunch of his little parades there. Two more people have now been shown to have committed voter fraud there. Charles Barnes, Jay Ketzik. So 164, 163, they've admitted to casting more than one vote during the 2020 election. This is a form of voter fraud, you'll be shocked to find out. A third degree felony that carries a prison term of up to 5 years, to which I say, don't put them in jail for 5 years. It didn't sway an election. It didn't matter. No. Now, to be fair, Barnes has not declared his party affiliation, but Ketzik was a registered Republican during the 2020 election. And it's the Villages, so it's not, I don't think, going too far to speculate that they both might have been Trump voters. And look, take it seriously, give them a warning or whatever, but it wasn't thousands of votes. Let's bear in mind that when the voter fraud, again, when it comes up, it tends to be Republicans, but nobody should be going to jail for 5 years because of this.
No, I mean, nobody should be going to jail. I don't think any amount of time for this. Maybe they need to do some political education classes, like maybe some civics classes. I would like to see that. Like here, civics 101, how the government actually works. Mm-hmm. That could be a form of, you know, actually teaching a teachable moment there. But nobody should be going into jail for such a small petty crime. And at the end of the day, yes, it's always Republicans, and it's not, you know, Shadow Acorn that is registering massive amounts of voters off the rolls and dead people. It is actually people who exist who are committing voter fraud in very small ways, and they should actually get civics lessons. That's my opinion.
I think that's a
great
point.
Give them all civics lessons.
Well, I have got a great development for you, Nelini. At least in this case, that is one of the things they're gonna have to do. Barnes and Ketzik have to complete 50 hours of community service. They have to attend a 12-week adult civics class called We the People, the Citizen, the Constitution, and they need to get a C- at least. I would like to see Trump actually take that too. We're gonna work on that. Oh my. For more political news, breakdowns, interviews, stories of activism, and me trying my hardest to care about the occasional big celebrity news story, subscribe to our YouTube channel at youtube.com/thedamagereport. And you can ring the bell wherever it is so you don't miss anything.